course, this is a completely new product for us. So this is a subcompact crossover. It's a relatively young segment, especially in North America, so there's really only a few kind of competitive offerings in that segment. And this is our take on it, and I think it's going to be a fairly unique position in the marketplace, and we're quite optimistic that this will further define what the segment is, you know, and be a very, very competitive offering. Currently, the subcompact segment's defined by cars like the Mini Countryman, especially the Nissan Juke. I think these are the primary vehicles that kind of have that segment at the moment. But it's kind of a wide range of products. There's not really a set specific definition for the segment. Our approach is a little bit more towards a compact but very, very sporty vehicle. Still has a distinct SUV proportion and stance to it, but the silhouette of the car is much more sleek and dynamic and coupe-like than the other offerings. The size of this car is very, very unique in that it sits in between what would traditionally be a Mazda 2 size and the Mazda 3. But obviously it's raised up in the air, so you have a completely different seating package and different interior space than both of those vehicles. So it represents a very unique balance of kind of a sporty hatchback upper, but an SUV lower with a higher ride height. And I can't think of any other real competitor that's taken that approach with the subcompact crossover. You know, I think that the crossover kind of evolution of cars, if you will, continues to evolve. It continues to splinter. And I think that there's some inherent advantages and things that I think the consumer base just simply enjoys, one of which is sitting high. I think being able to have a higher seating position and better road visibility is something that we take very serious in our packaging, and it's something that the CX-3 is really going to excel at. I think that the other big advantage is being slightly raised off the ground from a ground clearance standpoint, you know, with the road conditions or weather conditions, even simple things like going over speed bumps and into driveways. I think some customers like to be raised off the ground a little bit. What makes the idea of a sporty crossover like this so compelling is you get those advantages of sitting high and good ride height and being able to have a cold weather, good for cold weather conditions. But then you also get a car that's highly emotional, very sporty and very sleek. And that's something that I think is missing, especially at the lower end of the crossover categories. Now, this particular car is distinctly Mazda in that we've brought in the Kodo design language in a new and kind of evolved way with this car. The silhouette is very much Kodo design because the cabin is very swept back, has a really long hood on the car, and that's again completely unique in the segment. No other car has that. And it immediately gives it a more coupe-like or coupe-like quality, and I think that's something that will really, really set it apart and makes it distinctly Mazda. Aside from the exterior design, which is going to be standout in the segment, I really think the interior is a real highlight. You know, the exterior draws people in, but the interior is a whole nother level, especially for the segment. You know, we've really taken Mazda 6 and CX-5 levels of interior quality and craftsmanship, appointments and technology, and brought it down to the compact crossover segment. And that results in materials and technology, finishes, even simple things like leather and Alcantara inserts. It's really, really a class or even a class or two above the competitive set, and I think will be key to the CX-3's success in the marketplace.